Buckets off, everybody.
I'll never forget the first time I took a peek next to a stormtrooper and a Klingon. That could only happen at Comic-Con.
Okay. Hello!
How are you?
I'm fine, thank you. This is why it's important to coordinate your outfits.
That's right. See, I almost wore that.
Did you offer to make him something for this since you were getting all gussied?
Huh? I would make him one. Yeah, sure. Do you want to wear a space armor costume?
I should start wearing those,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah.
You command respect in that outfit.
Yeah.
Which I don't get much of.
Well, it's actually weird because I thought Commander Shepard was a guy. Mass Effect 3, everyone's decisions are so different. It's not the same story.
Customizable.
That's true. Comic-Con, the movie. So many of your films are more investigative in nature.
Yeah.
So I guess you hold Comic-Con in higher regard than McDonald's or Osama bin Laden.
Yeah, well, I think I just wanted to, this is a film that I felt was much better explored through the fans and the people who are living and breathing their everyday lives about the passion that is Comic-Con. Yeah. You know, whatever that piece of Comic-Con that represents their life is. Yeah. So, and then I also wanted to make a film for all the people who've hated every other movie I've made up till now.
Aww.
So for everybody who's hated, because people say, I haven't really liked any other stuff. And I'm like, well, you're going to love this film because I'm not in one frame of it. Yeah.
When they found Osama bin Laden,
yeah,
were you like, Pakistan, duh!
Well, no, the worst part is we were in Pakistan. And
yeah.
When the film came out, I remember when Where in the World came out, I was raked across the coals and the film got eviscerated and they were like, you were looking at Pakistan, like, who do you think you are? Who are you talking to? And then when it happened, suddenly like all the news networks were calling me and they're like, you were right, he was in Pakistan, you should come on and talk about it. And I was like, no, I'm all right. I'm all good.
Now, you've gathered a lot of different types of people of costume designing, people who are trying to get their artwork.
Yeah,
to
collectors.
A couple people I noticed you didn't put on there. There's no studio people on there because it's become so much of a commodity.
Well, we spoke to the people who are within the films, basically the writers, the directors, the actors who are in those films.
Yeah.
You know, we spoke to folks like that who are living and breathing within that world. And you have those people who talk about the value of it. Joss Whedon and Kevin Smith talk about it very succinctly, I think, as to them recognizing that there's something for them to capitalize on in this audience.
Yeah.
So, I thought that was a story better told than having, the head of a studio talk.
So many people, I think, are going to be watching this movie, like myself, going, where am I?
Yeah.
And I'm in it, actually. And so my question for you is,
Where's the coin?
Where's my cut? How many?
You filled out your SAG waiver,
yes.
Right? Yeah. Okay.
Yes, well, I did.
It's any day now.
Okay. Good.
Yeah.
Good. The Holly. So at the end of the film, we found out that you're working on Mass Effect. How's that coming?
It takes a while for these things to happen.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
When it does happen, I'm gonna be very excited.
Absolutely. How did they contact you for that? Was it just from the con, or did they hear?
It was through the film, yeah.
It
was actually through them seeing everything, and I think it is a Legendary Pictures film, I believe it's going to be. So
yeah, that's awesome. Is there like one thing like you're really looking forward to, like, if that hopefully it goes through, obviously, that you're looking forward to producing that you couldn't do in your garage?
Oh, I mean the whole thing. If I could have any kind of say on on what to help making the Mass Effect universe and the armor and the creatures real, even if it's just, helping design suits and things like that, it would blow my mind. It would be a dream come true, absolutely.
I want to get in already.
My wife's not too ecstatic about this whole toy collecting thing.
Let's go.
But I will not leave that con unless I have those figures.
Comic-Con is a job fair for comic book industry.
Let's just jump into the fire, as Duran Duran would say.
I read comics every day as a kid, and I really, really want to do this so badly.
Entry 11!
Comic-Con is a great place for exposure. And it's a big chance for me to get myself out there. It's about getting all your friends together and going on a suicide mission. And that's what this is. It's a suicide mission for my future.
I'm practically vibrating right now. I feel like I'm the Flash and I can just move through solid objects.
If I go back in time and tell like the 11-year-old me, like, one day not only do you go to Comic-Con, you go to Comic-Con every year, so much so that like you get greeted by Stan Lee when you show up. And the 11-year-old me would be like, how did we get so fat?